Welcome to the Street to Subsidy instructional video. Let's begin. First, open up your Google Chrome browser. In the URL, make sure you type in la.clarityhs.com/login. Enter your username, your password, and click sign in. You've now landed on our search page. It's important that we conduct a thorough search for our participant to ensure that we're not duplicating their record in HMIS. You can enter in their full name, partial name, date of birth, or any combination of. If your participant does not exist in HMIS, click the Add Client button to begin a new record. For the purpose of this video, I will be using my test client. A few important things to note before we move forward. From the client's profile page, take a moment to review all of the information that has been collected on your participant. Let's make sure that the information is accurate, that it's complete, and if anything is missing, now is the time to go ahead and input that information. Make sure that any changes or any additions to a client's record that you scroll all the way down to click on the Save Changes button before moving forward. If your household has additional members, please make sure to click back onto the search page, search for the next participant in the household. Once you select their record, repeat the steps of reviewing it to ensure accuracy, completeness, and you're going to want to repeat that process until all members of the household have been located in HMIS. If a household dependent does not exist in HMIS, now is the time to click on the Add Client button to add that dependent before moving forward. It is important that all members of the household are added to HMIS before enrolling them into the program. You may be wondering why that's important, and the reason is when it comes to enrolling your household, you want to make sure that they're all grouped together as one household. Neglecting to do that now will cause them to be enrolled as individuals and not as a household. Next, we're going to upload documents to your client's record by clicking on the Files tab. In order to upload documents, you must first scan and upload them to your computer. Then click the Add File button. Select the category that best fits the description of the document you are uploading. Then select the predefined name that best fits the description of the document you are uploading. Select Other if the predefined name option is not there, and type in the name of the document you're uploading. Click on the Select File button, select your document, and click the Open button. Toggle the Private button on if the participant opted to keep their personal information private. Otherwise, leave it as is. Then click on the Save Changes button. Repeat these steps to add additional documentation to your client's record. In this example, the Salvation Army has accepted this participant in their Street to Subsidy program. Therefore, we're going to click on the Programs tab. Scroll down to the Available Programs section and look for your program from here. Click on the drop-down. An important note, for households with dependents, you would see a list over to the left bottom corner that would show each household member. Be sure to enable each record for each of the participants that will be enrolling in the program with the head of household. Then click on the Enroll button. At this point, you will be asked to answer a series of questions, starting with the program start date. Complete the enrollment by entering in the required information. Be sure to use the drop-down menus to clearly identify what is being asked. Then click on the Save and Close button. Once you complete the enrollment questionnaire for each of the household dependents, you will be directed to the Provide Services tab. Services provided to participants, including financial assistance, must be recorded in HMIS as a service within 3 business days. Locate the service provided. Click on the drop-down icon next to the service you wish to document. Enter the start and end date. The date range would reflect the month the service is covering. Enter the dollar amount that was issued or paid. If not, leave it blank. Enter the expense date. Leave it blank if it's not applicable. If applicable, enter the date the financial assistance was issued. And leave the funding source as is. Then click on the Submit button. Your service placement has been added successfully. You may repeat this step to add additional services provided to your participant. Important to note, following intake and assessment, case managers must develop a housing and service plan in coordination with the participant and enter it into HMIS. The housing and service plan form can be found on LASA.org under the Documents tab. From the Provide Services tab, locate Housing and Service Plan. Click on the drop-down. In the Date field, enter the date the Housing and Service Plan was created. In the Time field, enter the time the Housing and Service Plan was created. In the Time Tracking field, enter the total time spent with the participant. Then click on the Submit button. Your service placement has been added successfully. We will also be showing you how to add the Housing and Service Plan case note. The Provide Services tab is also where you would be documenting referrals. Locate the appropriate referral from the list provided. Click the drop-down menu. Please note you have 3 options to choose from: attained, not attained, and referral made. The first thing you need to do is to record that the referral was made. You can do that by clicking on the drop-down. Enter the date and time of the referral, then click on Submit. During case management, follow up with the participant to see if any progress was made with the referral. Document whether the participant acted on the referral or not. Locate the referral service and click on the drop-down. Next, you're going to indicate whether the referral was attained or not attained, simply by clicking on the drop-down. Enter the date and time of follow-up, and then click on Submit. Be sure to repeat these steps for all referral type services. Changes in regular income, employment status, and/or disabling conditions and barriers must be recorded within 3 business days in HMIS as a status update assessment. Housing status must be updated within 1 business day in HMIS along with the move-in date and housing location. To complete an assessment, click on the Assessments tab. Locate the Status Update Assessment and click on the Start button. Then click Add Status Assessment button. Complete the form by filling out all of the required information. Then click on the Save and Close button. If participants are enrolled in the program for a year, an annual assessment must be completed in HMIS. A system alert will appear, which is a reminder that the annual assessment is due. If a status update was completed within the time an annual assessment is due, the annual assessment still needs to be completed. They will simply be identical. To complete an annual assessment, you would locate the annual assessment form here and click on the Start button. Then click on Add Annual Assessment button. Complete the form by filling in all of the required information. Scroll down and click on the Save and Close button. Last but not least, you would need to complete a population appropriate triage assessment. Check to ensure that a population-appropriate triage tool has not already been completed. There is no need to complete a new assessment if one has already been done. The only time a new triage assessment should be recompleted is if there is a change of status in the participant's life, such as an increased income or having a child that would significantly alter their score. Locate the appropriate assessment and click on the Start button. Complete the form by entering in all of the required information. Be sure to use the drop-down menus to clearly identify what is being asked. Then click on the Save button. The score summary will show you how the participant scored for each category. Case notes should speak directly to the goals in the housing and service plan. To create a case note, click on the Notes tab. Click the Add Note button. Create a title for the note as you would an email. Enter the date that the service was provided to the participant. Enter the amount of time spent with the participant. The note field provides specific detail about the conversation, including the household situation and what activities were done with the participant. Provide as much detail as possible. Toggle the private button on if the participant opted to keep their personal information private. Then click on Add Record button. Repeat the process to add additional case notes. To attach documentation to the participant's program record, click on the Files tab. Then click on Link from Files. Toggle on any documents that you would like to connect to your program record. Then click on the Link and Close button. To exit a participant from your program, click on the Exit tab. Begin entering the program exit information, starting with the program exit date. This is the date the participant is no longer active in your program. Indicate the appropriate destination. Reason for leaving. Indicate the appropriate reason. The remainder of the questions will auto-populate from the enrollment screen. Review all of the questions and update any information that may have changed. Fill out any fields that are left blank. Scroll all the way down and click on the Save and Close button. Note, if the participant does not want to disclose the specific address for the housing destination, enter Client Refused to Provide Address in the address line. At a minimum, service providers should enter the city and zip code of the participant's housing destination. Once that information is entered, scroll down and click on the Save and Close button. Thank you for watching.